What's up, guys? It is Bernardo from the BTNHD, and today is all about upgrading your Windows 10 ADK to version 2004, so let's get into it. All right, so today is all about upgrading to ADK version 2004. So before you do anything, make sure that you back up your MDT server, okay? Or wherever you have your Windows 10 ADK tools, make sure you back up that machine before you do anything, okay? So first things first, I am going to right click on my start menu and I'm going to go to run. And from here, I'm going to type in WinVer, hit OK. And I'm doing everything within a Windows Server 2019 server. That is what my MDT is running on. From here, we are going to click on start and I'm going to start typing in control. Click on control panel. And we want to go inside programs and features. And as you can see, I am running 18.3.6.2. for Windows 10 ADK. Now, this supports 1903 as well as Windows 10 1909. So the first thing that we need to do is remove these two things from our server, then go inside the Microsoft website to download the Windows ADK and then install it. So I'm going to select one and click on uninstall. It's going to start loading up. You're going to get this nice little prompt. Definitely, we want to remove it, so click on yes. It's going to start uninstalling all the features, and once it's completed, you're going to get this. Just click on close, and then within your programs and features, you're going to see that it's gone. Now, we need to select the last one and click on uninstall. You're going to get this nice little warning again. So click yes, because we do want to remove it. It's going to start uninstalling all the features, and once it's completed, you're going to get this, and then click on close. Once you remove everything within your server, it is time for us to download the latest Windows ADK 10 as well as install it. So open up your favorite browser. I will provide this link at the bottom of the comment section for you guys, so don't worry about it. One thing that's new at the site is that in the past, they used to advertise three things. They used to advertise the Windows ADK, the Windows PE, and also a batch file that's going to upgrade the WSMI. They're not advertising it for this version, so I'm assuming they fixed it. So download the Windows ADK and the Windows PE, which I already did. I'm going to click on the little arrow, show in folder. Everything was dropped inside the downloads folder for me. So what I'm going to do is select ADK setup, right click on it, and run it as an administrator. It's going to start loading up. You're going to get this. I'm going to leave everything as the default. Click next. Pick your poison, it's up to you. Once you pick yes or no, click next. Accept the license and terms. I left everything as the default, then click on install. It's gonna start installing the features, and once it's done, you're going to get this and close. Now, the ADK setup is the easiest one. It's only 1.1 gigs in size, but the Windows PE stuff is huge. I think it's around 6 gigs. So we're going to select the ADK WinPE setup. We're gonna right click on it, run it as an administrator. You're gonna get this. Click on next, pick your answer, click next, accept the license and terms, and then you only have one feature, that is the one that we want, and click install. This process takes a while. Once it's completed, you're going to get this. Then we are going to click on close. Now, the next thing that we need to do is click on start. We are going to locate our Microsoft Deployment Toolkit folder, open it up, and click on the deployment workbench. And what I like to do within my environment is I like to select my node, my MDT node, right click on it, update deployment share. You're going to get the nice little deployment share wizard. And from here, I like to do a completely regenerate the boot images. Every time I upgrade my Windows ADK, I like to do that. I don't know if it's best practice, but that's what I like to do, right? Click next, next, and it's going to start cleaning up. Once everything is done, you're going to get this. Click on finish. I opened up my WDS, which lives inside my MDT server. I went inside boot images, I right clicked on it, add boot image, I browsed, and I went inside the deployment share boot folder, and I'm going to click on my light touch PE64bit.wim file, and then I'm going to open that up, click next here, I'm going to leave everything as the default, click next, next here, and it's going to start adding the boot image, and boom, done, click finish. Now the next thing I like to do is select my primary WDS node, right click on it, go to all tasks, restart. And it's going to restart the services. And once everything is done, you're going to get this, right? Now, I'm going to give you guys a quick demo of how this goes out, because it looks like Windows 10 ADK 2004 is broken. Yes, sucks. Come on, Microsoft, seriously. But this video is all about getting yourself up and running. It kind of sucks because the process is basically remove what you have and then install the new one. That's why I say back up, okay? Because if you're doing this within a production environment and you did not back up, you're screwed, okay? You can always remove 2004 and then install, you know, the old 1903 ADK version. But sometimes that's hard to find because Microsoft drops it and they just replace the links to the new ADK stuff. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Do not stop. Continue watching. You're going to see a quick demo. You're actually going to see the error that I receive and a lot of people are receiving. Also, I have a video out showing you guys how to fix it. And that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoy. Make sure to punch, elbow, and smash that subscribe button. And also do not forget about hitting that like button. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.